See? Yeah. But every time I'm moving, you see I'm moving here? I'm moving here. You see my arm? I'm moving. I'm searching. I'm moving. You see? So I'm dancing with him.
Boom.
You see? I'm here. I control him. I move. You see? I'm behind. Yeah? I'm behind. I'm controlling. Yes?
What?
I'm moving. I'm in line. See? If you move this, then I got to be here quickly. Then I'm here. Yeah? See? Drop body. Position. See? Now I'm here. Yeah? Now you be here. Move quickly. Then I got to be quickly and be here. Yeah? Now things got to change fast. Yeah?
Yeah.
You see?
Yeah.
So you're not the same with
right.
Dan, but with Dan the intensity when he give me that.
But what's up everybody? This is Gian with Funker Tactical and Aperture Fight Focus. I have a huge treat for you. I have here, we got Don Gula, Hall of Famer,
hey.
Law enforcement,
officer, yes, sir.
Trainer.
Yeah.
We have Master Wong. Yup. No introduction needed. Of course Master Wong is here. We got my homeboy Sal Mascoli, United States Marine. He's a cop as well. We got another Marine here, my homeboy Gary. Guys, let's talk knife defense. How about that, okay? First of all, without so much of an explanation, let's just do a little bit of demo and slow, yo. Stop, okay? No, I'm gonna do it to you now. Stop.
Okay. Get your hand behind your back, sir. Stop resisting.
I got it, Donnie. I got it.
Okay, I got him.
I got it.
Okay.
Tap.
Put one finger up. He's
not
right. He's good.
I'm good.
Okay. Swap. Souvenir.
You saw similarities there. Come here, guys. You saw some, why? Can you please, I'm out of breath. Explain to us why,
okay.
More or less, slight differences, same
okay.
Concept.
Now, the idea is on this particular weapon goes slowly. Now, because it's coming from this line, I want to offset, okay? I want to be here. So this, what I want to do is I want to break this as I go. You see the hand as I go, I want to break this, see? Yeah. And then from there, I can do that, I can move, and then I can search weapon. That's one thing I do, because I'm from England, I don't able to grab it out and then start to stopping them, you know? Or breaking their shoulder and everything, because you want to control more. So that's a little bit different on
right.
When we do it. So on his one.
Sal, why, principally, why are we seeing more or less the same thing?
The thing is, for me, I'm not worried about anything else going on. I'm worried about the thing that's going to hurt me most, which is going to be that weapon. So to me, I'm engaging the weapon. Now, based on the direction and what angle you're bringing it in is the way I'm going to go. So you brought it in here, but it was in close. So I just redirected the energy here and then basically did the same thing.
So the same thing control here. See?
2-1-1.
2-1-1 here.
Another thing is, let me stop a second. Now you look here, try to hit him.
I know this, I'm not gonna try to, I know it.
So this is why some people don't get it, yeah? That's where the problem, because
yeah.
They're thinking, yeah, they can hit with this hand.
So, I can't hit with this hand. The moment I try to, bad things are gonna happen to me. Forget that what if.
So the angle that you brought it in at was here, so I redirected it here, and basically just went right back to my arm bar, and then controlling all your recoil, I put more of my body on you than you had available to your arm.
Right, meaning?
Surface area, I covered a lot of surface area. Just like if I'm shooting a gun, I control recoil, I'm doing the same thing with a human body, I'm controlling recoil. So this way I'm covering a lot of surface area. Then after we released you, you went after Big Gary, and you made the mistake of bringing your blade to the outside of Big Gary. And then he went.
Did I go outside?
Yeah, you went outside.
Yeah, so
you went outside.
To get all the way through here, right? Just here. The man with the arm.
Oh,
because
that
brought
him again, here. The same principle.
Yeah.
Okay.
Control.
That's right. Yeah.
Okay. No. That's hurt.
Yeah.
Woo! I can't struggle. So again, these are tutorial paced things, guys. We're not really fighting. So yes, when I can pause, I can go. I'm just gonna slap Gary in the face. I think I'm gonna do that right now.
What happened there?
But if Gary doesn't want me to punch him in the face. Oh God. Okay.
See, eyeball?
You Yeah. Wait. Ah!
And spit it out though. You never know.
Did you ever like do Wing Chun? Because you did that to me too.
Exactly the same. I when I'm here, I come in here, I control the same. God. But I control him here, on this bit here. Yeah, and when if you chop it chin down, I can't grab, then I chop it here. Yeah. And you see? And I still control this because this pressure never changed. What I ever do here, this pressure never changed. I just got a monitor. Then I got a problem, I go back to the same way. Yeah? So principle, everybody using the same method, same line. Is it we made a shit up?
No. Huh? It's like we all made it up together.
Yeah.
Alright. So and the other thing is this. Alright. He started to move in on Don, and then I saw a body. Yep. I saw body positioning.
Was that a cop thing?
That was a cop.
That's not a martial arts thing. That's kind of gangster a little bit.
That's my paw.
Look at that. Sorry. I wanted to go training. I didn't know what he's doing.
That's a martial art. But this is important. It's an important point to illustrate.
That's right.
Even in this context,
that's it.
You have to infuse a little bit of energy.
Of course.
Even if it's on a mindset level. I'm trying to stab you.
That's it. You have to, because then you can't feel it. You can't feel in the way the body moves. You know, that's why you got to make sure the movement. And sometimes online especially, people, when they do something, say, oh yeah, but it's no such thing as but, because when your contact come, it's a way to respond, meaning multiple joints been broken at that movement in. Not like I play with him like we're dancing. Not like, it's not like this dancing, yeah? You see the way we're dancing? Yeah. But every time I'm moving, you see I'm moving here. You see my arm? I'm moving. You see? So I'm dancing with him.
Boom.
You see? I'm here. I control him. I move. You see? I'm behind, yeah? I'm behind. I'm controlling. I'm moving. I'm in line. See? If you move this, then I got to be here quickly. Then I'm here, drop body, position, see? Now I'm here, Now you're here, move quickly, then I've got to be quickly and be here. Yeah? Now things got to change fast. Yeah? You see?
Yeah.
So you're not the same with dance, but with dance the intensity when he give me that.
But it also doesn't mean that I can't.
Exactly.
That. It doesn't mean I can't, it just means it's not a guarantee, man.
That's right.
And you know I might do this and do all, but you don't care. No. You'll maybe take a superficial cut to end the fight, wouldn't you?
Yeah. But another thing is good as well to understand is when it came, you automatically don't let him even give him the chance.
Yeah.
Okay? Automatically to have the intensity to hurt him real bad.
Yeah.
But you need to have that feel into you.
Yeah.
But we're playing to get an idea.
One of the things, you're moving from a position of control to a position of control. You're establishing position before you transition to something else. Because if, oh my God, what is he doing to me? What is he doing?
See, now full control, see?
Easy. That's it.
You know I love you. Go ahead, sorry to interrupt you.
No, it's perfect.
So,
you were saying?
Yeah. So, establish position before I transition. All right, if I start trying to do something before I'm controlling things.
See, it's all sort of thinking bad thing can happen.
So, my thing is, I want to control something. Beat his arm.
That's it, upset the positioning.
Stop.
Yeah. See, that's the difference that people don't understand. Because they can't see it, they can't feel it. They don't feel it, you see? That's why when you watch it, you can't feel it. To when you feel it, you understand it. Because the most important thing you need to understand as well, everything like that, if we get good position, no more people are just, you just crank, bang, break down. Yeah, straight away, boom, headbutt coming in, and then you're dealing with this arm straight away. And then, bam, to the bam, and then I see if you can boom, come, grab, and you can do many things here. But you see, I don't put pressure here. Move, that's it.
Wait, let me move.
Move.
I cannot
see,
move. I should be able to circle, right?
Exactly. This is a big problem. And people, and especially people go and say, oh yeah, I can move. You can't move when I feel you.
Yeah.
I feel you respond. We train on this to make sure we control you. So everything is safe and we can train. You wanna ask something on?
What do people need to start doing that they're not doing enough of?
I think it's just shut the fuck up and listen and train.
What about you? What are people not doing enough of in martial arts?
Well, a lot of the things that we just talked about here is that when this blade comes into me, we're talking about these controls.
Basic stuff.
I don't want to be out here playing with.
Yeah.
You just try to knife me, man. I'm really pissed, man.
Okay, I'm out.
Okay. Gary's the man. So, what are we not doing enough of?
I don't want to be fighting this. I want to try to end this quickly. Whether it's a break, whether it's a knockout, whether it's taking this guy's tool away from him, I want to end it quickly. The longer he has that tool, the more chance of that tool coming to him.
And one of the things that I see a lot of times, and a lot of guys coming out with videos, and more power to you, evidently you want to make a video like this, that says why knife defense doesn't work.
Nothing.
What are you supposed to do? All right. Oh my God, he's got a knife. It doesn't work. Just attack me, kill me. I give up.
Yeah.
All right. But the thing is this, everything works and nothing works. It's based on, you know, how good the bad guy is, how good the good guy is, whatever that is. And things could change, dynamics could change. And at the same token, even if you get touched, I'm not done.
That's it.
You fight through it. And the thing is, and if you understand principles of certain things, you'll find a technique or find something to do. Because at one point, I don't know how you got on my back, but somewhere during the course of that. You got on my back. So what did I do? I saw your hand.
You find something.
And I pulled it forward so it would roll.
Right.
And I just put all my pressure because I could care less what else was going on. So again, you find technique through principle.
Yeah.
You know principle, technique.
Techniques are endless. Thank you so much for watching. Listen, these guys aren't just giving out here for free. These guys paid a lot of money, sweat, blood, and tears, and time to gain this knowledge so that you guys can get it for free. So here's the least of what you can do. I want you to follow these guys. I want you to pay attention to who they are and what they're doing. Let's improve the conversation. Let's start with Gary. Where can we find you, or if you want to be found?
A Wrestling, www.awrestling.com, or Raider Tactical.
Raider Tactical.
You just find me as the Master Wong.
We got Sal here. Where?
IDO underscore consulting at Instagram,
yeah.
and I do tactics at YouTube.
Right. Sergeant Donnie.
Wrestling.com and nextleveltraining.com.
All right, so I'm gonna count on you guys as martial artists, as fighters, to really honor this pact. Like I said, these guys have spent more time learning their craft than doctors do. It's time that we start paying homage and really respecting who martial arts and fighting and defensive tactics instructors are. This is how we allow the cream to rise to the top, and this is how we have better conversations in fighting. So on behalf of all of these communities, guys, thank you very much.
Right,
you're good for watching.
Right. Okay, man.
Oh, everybody attack those guys!
Hey, you guys.
All right, we are here, Budo Brothers, with Master Wong.
The man.
And we have some big news. As you know, Budo Brothers is all about giving back to our community that has given us so much, because at the end of the day, martial arts changes lives.
Absolutely.
We want to continue to do this work, but we need your help. We had an idea at this super show of how we can engage more school owners to give back to the community in the ways of helping the most deserving kids that they know by granting them access to their school. So what we're asking, Mr. Wong.
You spin it.
So what we want to do, like me, Marsha give me a lot of stuff. I've been bullied very young. in Vietnam, come over, and what Marshall made me to become who I am today, confident to become the better version of me. Everybody make mistake in life. Everybody do bad thing, but they got a chance to change. Now, what we want to do with a lot of Master Seafood together is helping to raise awareness, to helping the kid got no chance, okay? No chance at all to get involved in Marshall, to bring themselves up, to become more what they want to be in life. Okay, so what we want to do is gather all the martial people around the world, okay, school owner, to helping to work together as a family to make this happen,
yes,
to helping everyone to give them a chance to be able to become more better version of them. If you like that and you want to be a part of that, contact Budo Bada.
Let's
and
do it.
We will make this happen. We want to changing 1 million kids in this 5 years.
Yes.
Okay?
That's our goal.
1 million kids in this 5 years. So if you want to be part of it and you feel that you've been affected and Marshall changed you, then join us. If we join together, we can walk very far. And if you're on your own, you can go quick. But you will die. No one give you water. You'll be thirsty, my friend. But you work with a team. If you can't walk, we will help you and carry you through and get into the journey where we want to go. You know where that is? I don't know where that is. But this doesn't really matter. We're in a journey together. And that's what it's all about. Master Wong here.
Budo Brothers.
Join the team and we will fight for what you want.
1 million kids.
Million kids in five years. Help us out.
Let's do it, people.
Let's do it.